now to an extraordinary look inside the world of Apple, the company that makes those gadgets that millions of us love. Nightline anchor Bill Weir was granted exclusive access to a factory in China run by Apple's biggest supplier and brings us, this is a fascinating
It's
report.
Really something. No one's has seen exactly what goes on in there. For years, we've been asking the world's most valuable company for a glimpse inside. For years, they said no. But after serious allegations of forced overtime, underage labor, after explosions and chemicals killed and harmed workers over there, Apple's been taking increasing heat for the way they run their factories, especially the biggest supplier called Foxconn. And as pressure mounted, they invited not only us, but also the Fair Labor Association, a trade group, to audit Foxconn, publish results. No matter how ugly, they said we could talk to anyone, go anywhere we wanted to. And here's a little sample of what we saw. It's all so stylish. The see-through stores, the pristine white packaging, touch screens, all the more touchable since the company that makes them has been shrouded in tantalizing secrecy. Until now.
I'm told this is the very first time any reporter from any country has been allowed to see this.
We don dust-free bunny suits to watch a room filled with massive robots glide around with sheets of iPad glass.
Wow, look at that. It's like a scene out of Wall-E.
But these lines are the futuristic exception. And with Apple's reputation under fire, we're most interested in the people who build their complex gadgets one tiny piece at a time. As a whole, it's an incredibly complex process, but look at the individuals and you see mostly teenagers from the countryside, 17, 18-year-olds far away from very poor homes.
So this is home.
They live in a dorm with seven strangers, spend 6 days a week repeating the same task again and again. Fatigue and boredom are common in any factory, but this one is surrounded by suicide nets. They are everywhere. A horrifying reminder of 18 workers who jumped from the buildings here at Foxconn City in the past few years. The suicide rate in this massive company is lower than average in China. But after people jumped in such a sobering cluster, Foxconn opened a counseling center and raised starting wages about 25 cents an hour.
I wonder, though, if it wasn't for the spate of suicides, did it take something that severe to make you rethink how you treated your workers here?
I think absolutely. What we are facing is changing in a much rapid pace than we could have anticipated in the past. Right? So we are also changing.
As the Fair Labor Association collects employee grievances on, get this, iPads.
You can be honest.
We talked to dozens of employees, on camera and off, and the most common complaint, low pay. Most, like Zhao Xiaoying, can't afford to live with their own children, much less buy one of the products they help build. While she carves thousands of Apple logos onto the backs of iPads every shift, she's never actually seen a working iPad.
What do you want the people who end up buying this to know about you?
I want them to know me, she says. I want them to know we put a lot of effort into this product, and when they use it, please use it with care.
By our standards, it is really soul-crushing work, but we also visited some villages where a lot of these people come from, and they say their lives are better because of the factories. The alternatives are so much worse. There's still a lot of sweatshops there. And for the record, ABC's parent company, Disney, does have close ties to Apple. Our CEO sits on their board, the estate of Steve Jobs, largest shareholder in Disney. But when Apple came calling, I said those ties would have no bearing on our reporting, although we didn't see any egregious violations. If the Fair Labor Association does find them, we'll report those as well going forward.
Well, that report shows that you're going to be really fair about this. But let me ask you something else, Bill, because people watching this at home, it's an American company.
Right.
They employ, what, a million people?
A million people.
3,000 were hired the day that you were
there.
And a lot of folks are saying, couldn't those be jobs here in the U.S.?
I wondered the same thing. But you realize it's not just the cheap labor. It's not just people willing to do that and live in dorms for $2 an hour. It's the ecosystem. You have no idea the scale. The Chinese decided 30 years ago, we're going to take millions of little pieces from thousands of different places and build stuff faster than anybody. And to be honest, in our current world, you can either be the country that lines up to make this stuff, or you can be the country that lines up to buy it.
Yeah,
but it's impossible to be both.
All right, Bill, thank you. Again, just absolutely fascinating. He will have much more on that stunning and exclusive report on World News and a special edition tonight on Nightline.